first time meeting, so
yeah,
you could say that actually helps her out a bit more.
Nice serve, deep serve.
Yeah. Backhand serve. Mm. Ooh, look at that. Surprising how good that was. Really big movement there, big swing. Joy Kim couldn't quite get there.
3-2.
The posture of Doo Hoi Kim just seems a little bit more stable. And I wonder how much that's going to help her here with that middle ground, because it's not about how many good shots you play.
Right.
It's that middle area, it's that baseline level. The cement that holds the outstanding bricks together. Doo Hoi Kim is so, so good. Been at the top level for a long, long time.
Yeah, interestingly enough, she does kind of struggle a little bit against lefties. Less than a 50% win rate. So these are the things you hold on to if you're a mischeck. Just explain for us, Fraser, why that is an advantage to be in a left-hander. Just, is it just because there's just so few of them?
Yeah, there's less of them. So they get more practice against righties than righties get against them. But also because there's less of them, you don't see them as often. So, you know, end of the day.
And where your shot might be going to someone's forehand, backhand is actually a forehand for a left-hander.
It depends on if they've got a better backhand or forehand.
Correct.
But usually players have a stronger forehand, so yeah, that's a good point. The longer length of the table is cross table, which goes into the strength of a lefty. So you've got to play the parallel especially well if you're the righty, really. Feels that way against top-level lefties, the ones that you see on TV. Would have been expecting this scenario, Doo Hoi Kim. Being 1-0 down, because obviously Polkanova, Austria, is number one. She will have a chance to meet Polkanova if she wins this match.
Yeah, that's the anticipated one, isn't it? Very quickly, 6 game points for Doo Hoi Kim. And she wraps it up quickly. Doo Hoi Kim, who serves.
One block.
So, Fraser, what do you think? Like, what does she need to do here?
I think that she's got to be as awkward and weird as possible in her approach. She's got to just do...
Take lessons from you.
Thanks, mate. I think she's got to be an orthodox.
Different, right?
Yeah. Serve from a different place. Constantly try and change your spin on the serve and the depth. Stamp your foot on the serve. Maybe try and play a few mind games. Draw it out, prolong it. You know, make it a match. Or it might not be in terms of level. Let's try and make do like I'm impatient.
Three, four.
Don't try and match her at her own game, because there's only going to be one winner there. See what I mean, Shahzad?
Absolutely. Till the words right out of her mouth.
Four, four.
I bet.
Well, thankfully, we can talk about the momentum. Duhoy Kemp is dominating it at the moment. 13 of the last 16. The mischeck is down to play the fifth. If it comes down to it, so she'll have got to glean as much as she can from this match. That's a great shot.
Yeah. Really flat shot there. Have to time it well. Actually bent the wrist, yeah. More of a fanning style, yeah. Yeah.
Really nice.
Fan think. Of that.
Let four or.
Well, I can tell you that this check is laid in that WTT contender in Doha. Lost opening match to Audrey Zarif. Only match so far of 2024 before this. Just trying to punch at that one. I think, Fraser, you and I up here, it's actually a lot warmer than it is down courtside, because all the players are very much wrapped up
in
their jackets and scarves and all that. So, yeah, it certainly feels... It is. It was about 2 degrees this morning in Busan. And clearly it's pretty cold down there as well.
I mean, at least there'll be no humidity issue, which is the biggest enemy of a pro TT player. But,
it's true.
Yeah, not ideal in terms of coming in off the bench. You've got to maybe give a bit more in your warm-up and stretch a bit more, jump around a bit more before
true.
Your teammates' match finishes.
7 degrees outside right now. The action is hotting up in here. Duhoy Kemp 8-6 now. Much better overall, you'd say, from this check?
Yeah, I'm liking the way she's trying to play with loads of spin. Take a bit off the shot in terms of power and just try and get a bit more dwell. But
which is what you were kind of wanting, weren't you? Something a little bit different.
Mm. But is it different enough? Good serve.
7-8.
Lovely on the serve there.
Very brave to do a long serve into the forehand of Duhoy Kemp, but obviously had the surprise factor. Went for it again there.
9-7.
Could she have played the backhand instead? Well, it was in the middle. So I guess from there she fancied it more.
For 3 game points for Duhoy Kemp to make it 2. That was a deep shot, wasn't it? And that's wrapped up. Mischeck with it all to do here in this third game. Oh, that was a chance, wasn't it? Third ball attack. Didn't take it.
Again, I mentioned the posture early on because it is a differentiating factor, not just between these two, but in terms of a European lady and a East Asian lady. You can really see the difference in technique. Usually, you get a higher trajectory of ball against a player like Miscek, who's a little bit more upright when she plays the backhands, forehands, which makes it a little bit easier to counter. It's very wristy backhand that she has, and you even see it with the very best in Europe, like Soch. Duoi Kemp plays from countries like Hong Kong, China in general, and Korea. More compact, more efficient with their strokes.
So now, you feel, and it's not often that Miscek has had a lead here in this match so far. Can she do something with it? It's a platform for her.
Best rally of the match.
Couldn't quite keep it going.
Brilliantly played there from both. Look at this. Both getting it into each other's middles, but that last one too suffocating for Miscek. Who made the mistake?
So now Duoi Kemp with a three-point cushion. I think we're going to see a timeout here. Bit of a dire position here, aren't they? In just a short while, Miscek knows that
7-3.
If she doesn't do something very, very quickly, now trailing by four, it's all over, because that's also the number of points that Duoi Kemp needs to win this match.
8-3.
Well, again, I'll reference that first one. Polkanova guaranteeing that she'll have a chance to play again.
Yeah.
And guaranteeing that Duoi Kemp will have to play her.
Yeah.
But you can only play a player that's in front of you in the situation
Correct.
You've been handed. And yeah. Personally, I was never in doubt Duoi Kemp would win this.
12 of 16, yeah. This has been quite one-sided so far.
As long as she kept her structure, kept the basics right, Duoi Kemp was always going to win this. I've been impressed with Miscek and her speed recovery, fitness. Strung some nice stuff together, but it is that middle ground we come back to. Well played here by Duoi Kemp.
Look at all those match points now for Duoi Kemp. And as pretty much expected, Duoi Kemp.